Buongiorno a tutti, sono Elvira, ci troviamo ad Amatrice, questo è il mio paese e oggi sono qui per cucinarvi gli gnocchi ricci, una pasta tradizionale antica della nostra terra.
Amatrice is a town in the mountains of central Italy. It is famous for its amatriciana sauce, served with bucatini or spaghetti. But we're here to discover gnocchi ricci or curly gnocchi, pasta hardly known outside the area. Elvira explains why so few cooks can make it.
Veramente la pasta io l'ho imparata in tarda età. La mia mamma li faceva in un altro modo perché non li sapeva fare. Le donne di qui non rivelavano il segreto a nessuno. Li poteva vendere e poteva essere di aiuto per il sostentamento della propria famiglia. E quindi era un segreto che non andava assolutamente rivelato.
Elvira wants the world to know about it, so here goes. She makes two doughs, the first with 350 grams of 00 flour and 5 eggs. One where she removes the egg without cracking the shell. This is to measure water for the other dough. She quickly kneads this dough, which has a soft and sticky consistency.
Adesso iniziamo il procedimento per il secondo impasto.
To make the second dough, Elvira takes 2 eggs of water and brings it to the boil with a pinch of salt. She adds this to 150 grams of 00 flour. She makes the dough separately because the boiling water would cook the eggs.
Adesso dobbiamo unire.
She combines them by placing the water dough on top of the egg one. She kneads them so they are completely mixed together.
Appena si è amalgamata completamente, la nostra pasta è pronta.
Here you can see the dough is uniform in texture and color.
Ecco, il nostro filoncino è pronto. Iniziamo la lavorazione dei nostri gnocchi. Ecco, è morbida, morbida.
Keeping the pasta wrapped to stop it from drying out, Elvira cuts off a bit at a time and rolls out a rope.
È morbida, guarda. Allora, facciamo le persone serie qua.
She slices it to create nuggets or gnocchi.
Gnocchi.
To create the curls, she keeps her board really well floured. She puts a pasta piece between her thumb, forefinger and third finger and drags it along the board. She flips it over and the result is a kind of wrinkled orecchiette. It's not easy, as I found out.
Perché se non lo incastona si allarga tutto.
Watch out for a total disaster. You have your middle finger, which is the most important one. That's the one that does the dragging and makes the wrinkles. Your wedding finger and your forefinger are the ones that are the guide to stop it from spatting out, I think. And the ditto the thumb underneath. And it's easy. And then you put the pressure on with your middle finger.
Delicato.
Delicato.
Delicato. Io sembra che spingo, ma non spingo. Delicato.
It takes a lot of practice, and I think it's in the top 3 most difficult pasta shapes to make in Italy. So if you're a pasta enthusiast, this is your next challenge.
Devo essere sincera nel dire che ci ho impiegato un bel po' per imparare a fare gnocchi ricci. I primi 2 ricetti ho capito, ce l'ho fatta.
The traditional accompaniment is a mutton ragout. Elvira chops up celery, carrot and onion and sautés the mixture in olive oil.
Adesso stacchiamo un attimo perché si devono cuocere 2 minuti prima di mettere la carne.
Ok.
La passione che mi riempie più di gioia in assoluto è la cucina.
She adds mutton ribs and minced beef.
E un po' di sale.
This is followed by a little bit of red wine and two tins of tomatoes, which she's mashed up with her whisk. She seasons it with salt and leaves it to cook for a couple of hours. Elvira adds the gnocchi to boiling salted water. As soon as they bob to the surface, they're ready. She dresses them with the tomato sauce and equal quantities of Parmigiano and Pecorino cheese.
I nostri gnocchi ricci sono pronti. Buon appetito! Che belli! Te li mangiamo?
The wrinkles are excellent for catching the sauce. It's a shape well worth mastering. Buon appetito!
It's fabulous! It's so delicious!
Click on the subscribe button for regular helpings of Pasta Grannies.